I'd like to give the floor to the Netherlands now. Mr. Becker, you have the floor, sir.
Thank you very much. Dear Stefan, Director General, I think it's very important you organized this meeting. I will concentrate on two issues. The issue of price volatility and the issue of the participation of the private sector. The challenge, we all know it. I don't repeat the words of several colleagues this morning. The front pages, they tell us a story about the problem that the demand is much higher than the supply of food. Price volatility is in the world. Food prices are sky high and the poor are paying the price. To my opinion, this price volatility is here to stay, and we need to mitigate its negative impacts. Working in these volatile conditions should be a part of our challenge. Building on the results of the G20 summits and its development of the AMIS, the Agricultural Market Information, should give further guidance on how to deal with volatile prices and markets in changing climate. I support the words of my German colleague who asked us all to support the implementation of AMIS in our countries. However, there are no simple answers. International organizations like World Bank and FAO gave already clear directions. Calming the markets should be our first priority. Food security can be achieved cannot be achieved in a single country. Governments and the international community should act in a coordinated manner. Unilateral measures are not helpful. Improving market transparency, for example, by publishing reliable statistics is a good instrument. Avoid panic buying. Encourage the consumption of substitute products because the prices hikes concern only a few commodities. We should, in international level, mitigate the risk of speculation. That's the issue of price transparency. Then the private sector. I fully agree with my colleague from Eritrea when he makes the point that we as international organizations, we as national governments, do not produce food. Food is produced by 1 billion farmers, more than 80 and 90% small farmers. We know the answers on the food security problem. In the international level, as professionals, we know the answers. But we didn't be effective in implementation of the concepts. And the key word in implementation, to my opinion, is how to reach that 1 billion farmers, the small farmers, in several countries. What do they need? They need access to land. They need knowledge, traditional knowledge and innovation. They need local financial instruments, that kind of things. When I look back to the Netherlands, the last 50 years, we have been investing during 50 years in our agriculture policy in the family-owned small farmers. Production conditions, knowledge, education, access to financial instruments and that kind of things. And to my opinion, our challenge on a global level and in a different countries is working together with the private sector, with the small farmer, family-owned farmers in the several countries. So we need a kind of a paradigm shift in implementation. A paradigm shift in implementation to the small farmers together with the private companies in the more developed countries. Private-public partnership. Small scale, concrete, local. I hope that we can make steps forward in this way. And the Dutch government and the Dutch private sector is a partner in this process.